I think it's like a universal story, isn't it? It's about saying yes to adventures and not staying comfortable in your own environment, saying yes every day to something new. And the underdog, the young hobbit that takes on the world, you know, it's such a beautiful story, really. I play Ori. He's one of the 13 dwarves that go on the adventure. And I guess Ori's kind of like a fish out of water, really. He's like the anti-dwarf. All the other guys are big and butch and got axes, and I've got a slingshot and I'm a knitted cardigan. Because he's really, really a fish out of water. He really shouldn't be on this journey, but kind of ends up going on it and just proving that he's a bit of a warrior as well, although he's still Ori and a bit of a nerd. I love it. I love him because there is a big kind of a strong warrior in him, but it's kind of hidden deep under knitted cardigans.
You're working with an astonishing cast, particularly, I mean, like Ian McKellen, Martin Freeman. Can you talk a little bit? I mean, especially Sir Ian, it's obviously mentioned that the dwarves and I think Gandalf have a very special relationship. He had a very special connection with them, I think.
With the dwarves?
Yeah.
He does, yeah. Yeah, I did. He's just a fantastic man, and I'm so honoured to call him a friend now. You know, he's one of the most funniest men you'll ever meet, Ian, and of course Martin is incredibly funny too, and they're both such good people and very, very funny. So we laughed a lot on sets. Yeah, I was on the job for about two years, so that every day we were always laughing. It was literally like a boy camp. We were just on. But the fact that we were in these ridiculous costumes trying to do things and maneuver our way, even just little things like sitting down for breakfast or sitting down in the catering tent and trying to see these 13 actors trying to eat and the bits of pasta getting stuck in their beard. And it just was always funny. Yeah, it's great fun.
I mean, we're about to get our second installment, The Desolation of Smaug. What can fans expect? I mean, I think obviously there's some particular scenes I think people are really excited for. The barrels, I think, we're very excited to see that.
Yeah, me too. Was one of my most fun times on set, I think. It's just like a Peter Jackson's kind of theme park ride in the middle of New Zealand, in the Pelorus River, seeing Stephen Hunter, who plays Bomber, trying to get into a barrel.
But put you in barrels. It wasn't just a little bit of CGI trickery. They really did shove you in there.
Oh yeah, we were in barrels. We were in barrels, and we were being taken down this amazing river. It was just great. It was one of the first days actually that we, as dwarves, we were cold. So it was really good because the water was freezing. Before that, we'd been really hot, but it was that was so much fun. I think this film in particular is going to be a bit of a roller coaster. I mean, there's no setup in this. You just jump straight in and we're off on a huge adventure. We've got so many things to cram into this film, and then you have the dragon at the end. So it's gonna be a very exciting roller coaster.
Of course, I mean, we were at the Royal Premiere and. There was a lot of excitement, particularly about the high frame rate and the new style of 3D, provoking mixed reactions, I guess, initially. I think people taking a little time to get used to it. How did you feel the first time you saw the footage in that format, in the way it's meant to be seen on the big screen?
Actually, it's the only way I've seen it. I've just seen it in that format, and I loved it. I mean, Pete just introduces a whole new dimension to it. So it's... I think it's fantastic, you know. Yeah, this is... It's a first, and I think that's why it was was a bit odd to get used to at the beginning. But I think you sit down in the first 5 minutes, and then you're in the world, and it's crystal clear, and just you're there. You're in Middle Earth, so I loved it. Yeah. I guess the Battle of Five Armies was kind of a big key moment in the third movie, so we did a lot of extra shooting on that, and. And lots of training, getting ready and prepared for that kind of big battle scene. So, yeah. But Yeah, I'm excited as you are to see it in three. I mean, it was about two years I was out there, and I can't divide the films up in my head at the moment. But I'm sure when I see Desolation of Smaug, I mean, I've seen bits already, and it's incredible. But to see it as a whole, I'm sure I will feel like I know the third movie better.
You mentioned there the Battle of Five Armies. I mean, again, I think that's something that people are just very excited about, because one of the things that's defined the success, I think, of the Lord of the Rings and the Hobbit films now is how well they handle that kind of large-scale action sequence. Do you feel like it's potentially a sequence that might even surpass what we've seen before at the end of Return of the King?
Well, I hope so. I mean, Return of the King is incredible, but I think this is a whole different ballgame as well, you know? Hey, I don't know. I only know so much that's in Pete's head, and I'm piecing together the world of the Battle of Five Armies, but I can reassure you it's going to be epic, yeah. It's very odd, actually. When you're in Wellington, you do feel like you are just doing a very small film with Pete in a kind of oversized garage, really. But then, of course, you look around and you see the millions of dollars that are being spent on it. But yeah, I think Pete still has that. I think Pete 100% cares for these movies, and I think that's why they're working with him, and the movies are always such a success, because they're like from his heart and he wants to tell the stories. So yeah, it's been brilliant.